I wake up later at night, still in my room. Ow! My head has bumps on it. I got hit really hard. The ghost is gone now. I'd be able to feel it if it was here. So it didn't kill me. Is it going to kill me a little at a time? Dumb luck is enough to explain the fact that I've survived all these attacks. Is it not trying to kill me? My right arm is itching, so I look down. I can see pretty okay in the dark, so I can tell why. This is part of my power. My senses are getting stronger. My right arm has countless tooth marks. Oh, I feel dizzy. I could let the sensation drag me back to dreamland, but I stand firm. This is weird. I had a Shikigami. If that girl is the same spirit from before, then the Shikigami should have stopped her. So why is this happening again? I check the drawer I've been keeping them in. They've been shredded. The whole pile of Shikigami is in tatters. I thought each of them lasted one night, but evidently not. It must be putting more effort into its attacks so it could destroy all of them. Not good. I can only see a handful of intact Shikigami. Since Akane is gone, there's no way to get any more. That ghost can do whatever she wants with me now. So much for giving up on the cult. The day before the festival. Today we only have a morning assembly to go to. The internal conflicts between the teachers have been worked out, so the principal is conspicuously absent and the speeches are very brief. Then we head to class for some quick announcements. One other thing. There is a warning about dangerous animals in the National Forest, which is pretty much the entire forest. Everyone, be good boys and girls and don't wander in there. There will be guards during the festival too. A few weeks ago, there was also an announcement on ways to avoid being attacked by these animals, so let's go over that. Oops, I skipped something. The classroom gets noisy. These conditions have been reviewed for a long time. So many of you have probably heard of them. The objective is to prevent people from being attacked, but part of that involves making certain areas off limits. Almost all of the forests around the city will be off limits. So none of us can enter the forest for a while. The forest that we've lived with since birth. The teacher starts staring off into space. Jeez. She takes off her glasses and wipes the lenses. I thought she was pretty young, but she looks 10 years older now. We all know that anyone her age would react the same way to this news. So we can't go in the forest anymore. All the secrets hidden out there will be locked away forever. That Shangri-La with the fluorescent rotting trees. Various kinds of monsters. And secret organizations. In the end, I couldn't pin down a single piece of it. Oh well, nothing I can do. I don't really regret it. Now I can leave it all on the other side of the city wall. Okay, that's it for today. Sensei is back to normal. By the way, if you're not in any extracurricular activities, you'll still get marked absent. So remember to keep coming to class. Okay. Goodbye now. The last morning class before the festival. Everyone's excited right now. They're all chatting away. The festival starts on Sunday, tomorrow. Then we have a whole week of nothing but fun. The classroom is full of people discussing what they'll be doing. A week-long festival is a good time for love, too. There are a lot of impromptu couples forming just to enjoy the romance of it. This happens every year. Maybe Kodori and I are like them. Huhu, everyone's having fun. She looks like a shepherd watching over his young flock. Sensei, are you going out with anyone during the festival? Why do I have to tell you that? She looks like a different person. Scary. I run away. I'm clueless about these things. I've gotta go do something. I don't want to say it because it has something to do with a occult club. I've given up on occult stuff. Kotori told me to anyway. Ah, that does sound good. Every year there's some stuff going on the day before the festival. A miniature festival just for Kaza Matsuri residents. So it's a little more exclusive than the week-long festival that's about to start. Going to that with Kotori. But I need anti-ghost measures before I can feel safe playing around. Sorry.
いいと思うよ.
Yeah, but I'll be free this evening. Are you available then?
お祭りだし、出られるよ. うち放任主義.
Mine are so hands-off, they basically don't parent me at all.
寂しがりの小太郎君には辛いね.
No, I don't. I'm a big strong man.
うちのおかやんに甘えてみる?
We don't need no parents. That makes no sense. Besides, she'd probably tell me to go back to the gutter or something.
言わないよ。優しいよ。
Anyway, I'll call you sometime this evening.
小太郎君どんな用事なの?
I was gonna look up how to make a shikigami.
Huh?
Crap, it slipped out. That's right, Kotori. Did you ever finish organizing the occult club's old paperwork?
大体終わったよ。でもあの目録も使われることはなさそうだね。
Well, I will.
小太郎君が? その式紙ってのを調べるの? 式紙ってなんだっけ? ちらっと聞いたことはあるんだけど… ゲームの敵? ゲームの中とはいえ、暴力は良くないよ。
What are you talking about? They might appear in Japanese games, but they're a real sort of part of our mythology.
オカルト… 関わらないって約束だったのに…
I know, but something came up, so I have to do this.
どんな?
She's strangely serious. If I don't answer carefully, I might upset her. That day… Kotori should know which one. I saw a girl for just a moment. I don't know if the others saw her, but she was definitely there.
女?
Not a real girl. A spirit, I guess. She felt very strange, as if she was just imitating the form of a girl. And it turns out that girl's been haunting me for months. I tell her about all the ghost scares and shikigami stories in the past. The more I talk, the more Kotori's face goes pale. What's wrong?
式紙があれば、それを遠ざけられるの?
Until now, yeah. But after last night, they're all gone. Without press, I have no way of getting any more. I hear till the old occult club made some, so I was gonna look into that.
そうなんだ.
Before, it felt like too much of a hassle to try searching through all that, but now that they're organized, I might be able to find something. So, Kotori, do you remember reading anything about making shikigami?
どうだったかな?
Okay, I'll look for it myself. So I'll be gone until this evening.
ダメ.
Eh?
約束したよ. オカルトはダメって.
But I'm being attacked!
私が代わりに調べてあげる. それなら約束破りにならないよ.
You will do it? Well, thank you.
多分、私がやった方が効率いいと思うさ.
I guess so, since you sorted them, but I feel kinda bad making you go that far.
約束破る方が… もっとずっと悪いです。
I guess so.
こんな簡単な方法で約束を守れるんだから 相談してくれないとダメだよ。
Hmm, okay. Thanks for doing it.
任せときなよ。
Good luck with that. I'm gonna be attacked again if you can't find anything. Then Kotori goes to the club room and I kill some time. I wasn't expecting to have all this time. What should I do with it? I'm still planning to go to the festival with Kotori this evening. Maybe I should rehearse that by looking around for interesting places. All the town's resources are focused on this festival. There are tents and stands set up in front of the station. Adults are running around shouting. When the festival starts tomorrow, a huge crowd of people will rush forward here. Cars, bicycles, motorbikes. All traffic will be blocked. Only a few vehicles with special permission will be able to get in. All housing facilities will be filled, all eateries will be packed, and there will be no end to the customers at any of these stands. That will keep happening for a whole week. Kazamatsuri City transforms into that once a year. The mini-festival tonight won't have access to any of the same resources, but there should be lots of friendly events and shops. A lot of the performances are amateurish, but it's still a fun place to be. Going there as a group is perfect. Unlike the real festival, which covers the whole city, the mini-festival is limited to the area around the station. But that's still pretty big. I better map out our date. Welcome! That place is selling Frankfurters to the people running the festival. Then we'd go there and look at this. My eyes are drawn to a particularly flashy group of people. The farm girls are here already. A famous part of the festival, girls from subsistence farming families wearing traditional clothing from various cultures. They act as guides for many of the guests. The harvest festival is very multicultural. On the other hand, there isn't much here that's unique to Japan. There is no shortage of food and alcohol from other countries. We'll be able to enjoy a part of it later tonight. I haven't eaten yet. One German set, please! Coming right up. This guy's really excited. Here you go! I receive a paper plate full of food. Extremely filling, but it's only 500 yen. Considering how much competition he has, it makes sense. Wow! Exceptional white sausage, grilled chicken cuts, a German omelette, and sauerkraut! I wouldn't call the flavoring subtle, but it's really good. I am satisfied. Might as well do some reporting too. I see the group of farm girls again. Excuse me, I'm from Monthly Terror magazine. Could I take a picture? Eh? Could you get my good side? Sure, I prefer an interview, but... Eh? That works too. Which would you prefer? Whatever's better. Make up your mind. Hey, have you heard of Terra magazine? Absolutely, I love it. I'd like to write a little about your food for the online edition. Oh, sure, go ahead, take some pictures of my mustache. I'll probably take a picture of the food. I'm gonna be here for the whole festival. You people watching this at home can come whenever you want. I said it's the online version. Excuse me, I'm from Terra magazine. What are you building here? I see you've sniffed out the pavilions that fulfill the most important of all roles during this festival. These aren't stores, are they? Nope, these are portable bathrooms, and they're connected to the sewage system, so there's no chance of them filling up. Eh? Do you really need this many? Dumbass, do you have any idea what would happen without these? Well, not having them would be terrible, but... This year we've replicated toilets from all over the world, try a few out. I recommend the Indonesian toilet. It doesn't use any toilet paper, so it's eco-friendly. What do you wipe with? Your hand. What? That's disgusting. Everyone's in high spirits today. They're all happy to talk to me. I know I should write about Esaka-san's shop. That should kill some time. Huh? Forest is closed. I look at the sign. Something came up, so we'll be closed for a while. The owner. No date or anything. It must have been really sudden. I would have liked Esaka-san to be here for the festival. I feel someone looking at me, so I turn around. Is this place good enough? Yeah, the flow of guests we're expecting is. Some people are talking about festival preparations. Was I imagining that? I see them all over town. Now that some people are in costume, it takes a lot to draw attention to yourself. Some strange-looking people walk around normally. I hold my breath. I don't know why. My strengthened senses are detecting some abnormality that isn't visible yet. A tiny concern ruining the air of the festival. There should be nothing but fun out here, but it doesn't feel like it. There's something ghastly covering the town, forcibly covering up all the festivities. Kazamatsuri has a dark side to it. I've seen it for myself, so I know it's there. But what should I do? What can I do? The best I could come up with was not get involved. The 13th. The night when everything fell apart. I was afraid I'd lose everyone, even Kotori. That's why I've been ignoring it. If there is something lurking in the darkness, I have just one request. Please, don't appear in front of me. Please, stay where I can see you. It's fine. Kotori is only 5 minutes late. You're still in uniform? Did you spend that long at school? Making it? She takes the pouch out of her book bag and hands it to me. What's this? Can I open it? I pull out something very odd. I thought it would be a part of Shikigami, but it's a wood carving. A piece of wood in the shape of a mammoth. The wood is a very light color, so this might look like an animal cracker from far away. You really like mammoths. Huh? Anyway, how powerful do you think this is? Okay, I'll do that. I'm amazed you found out about this so fast and went to the trouble of making it for me. Thank you, Kotori.
どういたしまして?
I just hope it works. I feel like a weight's been lifted. I hope not. Somehow, I really do feel like it will work. The anxiety I've had all day is gone now. Some of this is probably a placebo effect, but I'll assume it's mostly because this thing actually can protect me. I need to repay you. What do you want? You know, I'm fine with that. We already agreed to do that anyway. Okay. The word occult is quickly becoming unacceptable for Kotori. I basically agree with her on that, so it's not a problem. I want nothing to do with that stuff. And with Kotori's carving, I think it might stay away from me. Don't worry, I fully intend to remain in denial forever. You're really paranoid about this, Kotori. So she was thinking the same thing. I understand. I'm not touching that stuff anymore. No, it's not. We're only just beginning to have fun here. From now on, we are going to enjoy the normal things in life in a normal way. At least, I'd like you to do that with me. I couldn't look directly at Kotori as I said that last part. I can just barely see Kotori's ears turning red as she looks down. Yes, she has blood flowing through her. It'd be kind of bad if she didn't. Then we go enjoy the mini-festival together. There's tons of food on sale. For once, Kotori lets me buy her stuff without any protest. So I bought her everything I could. My war chest was big enough. We wanted to try a lot of stuff, so we only had one serving of everything. We shared each of those single servings, so it felt like a date. Though we ended up buying separate copies of the stuff that was really good. There were tons of people, but as a result, we could ignore everyone else and be in our own little world. Lots of foreign things Japanese festivals don't have. A fairy tale made real. Kotori and I walk through that world. Nothing undesirable in sight. Not anymore. Now that I have Kotori's good luck charm, I can't see any of those things anymore. And there's one other thing I'll start pretending I can't see. The fact that Kotori can make something that wards off ghosts. If you think about it for a minute, it's really strange. Maybe he's going to wear that as part of some costume contest tomorrow. Okay. No, it's not. Some of these places are going a little overboard on the mini festival. It's world famous water, you know. Okay, let's drink it. Welcome! We have many different kinds. Here's Turkish underground reservoir water, 300 yen. It's not bad. What's this water that costs 0 yen? Japanese tap water. Why does every stand need to have a joke like this prepared? Gotta stay upbeat. A shooting range? How's that different? 300 yen for 5 shots. Choose either a blowgun or a bow. Stone Age weaponry? Come on, choose your weapon. Boomerang. Okay, since boomerangs come back, if you're exceptionally good, you get one for 300 yen. He actually has one, and it's a trap. We continue having fun. But like any fun evening, it eventually comes to an end. There is a carriage coming. Everyone be careful. Oh, Kotori, it's a horse-drawn carriage.
Basha da.
The road's covered in pedestrians, but they're making room for a huge bus-sized carriage to pass by. It's decorated with a number of wreaths. Those are nice horses. What are their names? Those horses are Photochemical Smog, Spam Mail, Narita, Divorce, and Negative Thinking. That's just being mean to the horses. They'll be participating in the big parade during the real festival. The carriage calmly passes through the sea of people. The first name seems really inappropriate for Kazamatsuri. Actually, I just want to know who thought those were good names. Perfect! My war chest was well spent. That's a very subtle way of missing the point. The mini festival has passed its peak. The number of people gradually falls. This is the Harvest Festival Committee office. All mini festival events have finished. In addition, construction will. A voice from various speakers set up here and there. The crowds all start applauding. The shops and stands start packing up and construction staff move in to replace them. The real thing starts tomorrow. Kotori and I half-heartedly applaud with everyone else and sadly watch the carriage disappear into the distance. That was fun. Stuff like this is really nice. Is this a date? I look at Kotori. She looks very soft right now. More so than usual, I mean. Maybe this is my chance. Push. Just one push. My dad once told me I was created on a night when he made just one push. I'm gonna learn from him. Hey, Kotori. I move toward her face. Kotori's eyes open up slightly, then fill with hesitation. Her heart is wavering, melting. If she really wanted to reject me, she would have done it by now. Is this gonna work? I resist the urge to rush forward. I slowly move my lips forward, trying not to scare her. Only a few millimeters before I touch her. She moves her face slightly to one side. Failure. After failing twice before, it doesn't shake me that badly. I pull back and pretend nothing happened. The festival's over now. 2 days from now, let's start writing articles. I just feel like starting on Monday. We can spend at least one day killing time. Yeah, I'll call you tomorrow night. I gently hit Kotori's head with the back of my hand. You can stop apologizing, you manipulative woman.